Hello all and welcome to this smart strategy for 60 days. The next 60 days, how you have to manage your time, what you have to study so that we will be able to clear the prelims examination which will be held on October 4, 2020. So how smartly we can prepare for this prelims examination? We know that because of this COVID-19, a number of students got partially or fully disconnected from the studies because of this lockdown. So two things we have to keep in mind. One, we have to stay motivated, and number two, we have to confidently prepare for this examination. So how to prepare for the next 60 days? That becomes very, very crucial in our life. Why I am saying this? The next 60 days is equal to next 60 years in our life. So one single day, if we miss, then we are missing one full year. Therefore, how to manage, how to plan, how to implement the plan effectively to crack this prelims examination is very, 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 very important question in this time. And that is why this video on smart strategy for the next 60 days. If you count the number of days, almost 60 days we have. And we have close to 8 weeks. So we will plan for the 8 weeks. We also will give you a detailed daily plan. There is a macro plan which I will be discussing now, and there is a micro plan which is there in the PDF which can be downloaded by you. Take the printout of this micro plan, paste on the wall study table so that you are following this plan and you are able to clear this prelims examination. It's about how well you are able to execute this strategy. Planning can be done, but execution is very, very important. Knowing is okay, but application of this knowledge is very, very important. So many of you will have to ensure this, that almost all of you will have to ensure this, that you are implementing the plan properly. Now, what is this plan? The plan is for next 8 weeks. In this macro plan, I have spoken about how you have to plan for your next 8 weeks. From today, you have 8 weeks for your October 4, 2020. There is a rule which you have to follow, right? Daily, you have to study 12 hours. Daily, you have to study two GS subjects, current affairs, CSAT, and some miscellaneous aspects. Take, for example, week 1, daily in the first week, you have to do two subjects. These two subjects should be complementing each other. For example, I have chosen political, I have chosen polity and modern Indian history. Right? These are complementing because a thorough understanding of polity can help you understand modern Indian history. A thorough understanding of modern Indian history will help you understand Indian polity. So these are good combinations. In the week number 1, you have to study polity plus modern Indian history plus CSAT plus current affairs plus multiple choice question on those areas which we have covered. So week 1, daily you have to do polity, modern India, CSAT, current affairs and MCQs, multiple choice questions. Come to week 2, the same subject will continue. Polity will be there. 50% of polity, week 1, 50% of polity, week 2. 50% of modern India, week 1, 50% of modern India, week 2. Then CSAT, then current affairs, and then MCQs. Which month current affairs, what portion in CSAT? All these things are given in the micro plan, which is why I told you to download and paste it on the study table so that you can follow it very religiously. Now come to the third week. In first 2 weeks, you have covered fully polity, you have covered fully modern Indian history. Now, come to the third week. You have to study these two subjects in the third week, geography and environment, plus CSAT, current affairs and MCQs. Now, come to fourth week, because it will take only 1 week for you to cover environment. In the fourth week, geography will continue. 50% of geography you have covered in the third week. Remaining 50 you are covering in the fourth week. Environment you have covered in 1 week. Now In the fourth week, you have to touch ancient India, medieval India, plus culture. These are very, very integrated subjects, portions. So geography plus ancient medieval culture will have to be studied in the fourth week. So when 4 weeks are completed, which subject and all you have studied? Polity you have completed, modern India you have completed, ancient medieval India completed, culture you have completed, geography you have completed, and environment you have completed. Remaining subjects in prelims examination, what are the remaining subjects? Economy, science and technology. Remaining subjects are economy and science and technology. Now come to the fifth week. Economy you have to study, right? Then science and technology plus CSAT, current affairs, MCQs, some miscellaneous. Week 6, since you have studied in the week 5, basics of economics. You can easily study in the 6th week, economic survey, budget and remaining portions of science, science and technology. Right? So end of the 6 weeks, you see all the subjects which are present in the prelims examination, you have covered. First 6 weeks, you have covered all the subjects. What subjects and all you have covered? Polity you have covered, history you have covered, geography you have covered, environment you have covered, economy you have covered, and science and technology you have covered. All the subjects are having current affairs, so current affairs also covered. So 6 subjects plus current affairs present in prelim syllabus, you have covered it very properly by the end of 6 weeks. Now 7th week and 8th week is only for revision. My dear friends, without revision, we cannot clear this examination. Revision is the key to succeed in this examination. Why? Because this examination is checking your retention. It is checking your retrieval. So only when you revise properly, you can retain properly. Only when you can retain properly, you can retrieve properly. So proper retrieval can be done only through proper retention. Proper retention can be done only through proper revision. So revision, therefore, is the key for success in this examination. Hence, week 7, week 8, you are only revising whatever you have studied in the first 6 weeks. Only revision, only revision. For example, 7th week revision will be polity, history, geography. 8th week revision will be economy, environment, science, technology. Apart from these, current affairs preparation will have to be done. That goes without saying. So revision of the current affairs will have to happen in the 7th week and the 8th week. Which month current affairs? What portion in CSAT? What portion in India yearbook? All these things are given in the micro plan. Therefore, see the micro plan in the PDF form. Now, this is about how you are going to handle the next 8 weeks. Right? Now, come to the daily action plan. Daily action plan. We have to study 12 hours a day. 12 hours a day is very, very essential for clearing this examination. 12 hours a day. Right? Daily, you have to touch 2 general studies subjects. Then you have to touch CSAT, current affairs, and certain miscellaneous items like India yearbook, maps, plus solving of the multiple choice questions. So 12 hours, 10 hours of study and 2 hours of writing test in the form of writing the multiple choice questions. How you have to handle this single day? 2 GS subjects will have to be touched on every day, I have told you. Take for example, week 1. 2 GS subjects I have told. One is polity, another is modern India. So, polity I'll study for 3 hours. Modern India I'll study for 3 hours. Then current affairs I'll study for 2 hours. CSAT, very, very important because many people do not clear the CSAT examination. Even though it is a qualifying paper, some importance you have to give at this juncture. So CSAT you have to study for 1 hour. Then map, always they are asking 2-3 questions on map. International map as well as national map. For example, the tributaries of rivers, Indian river system, they are asking. And therefore, when you read the map daily for half an hour, it is very, very important. It will be very, very useful. You can answer easily 2 or 3 questions out of 100 questions in the GS. Now, India yearbook, right? Half an hour you have to spend. Just of course, they are not directly asking questions from India yearbook, but still you have to do this because these are certain rituals which you have to do, whether it is coming or not, directly or indirectly, whether it is coming or not, you have to do the India yearbook. just fastly you have to glance. You need not spend more time on India yearbook. Just glancing will do. Just glancing will do, right? So 10 hours of study. GS 1, 3 hours. Polity 3 hours. History 3 hours. Current affairs 2 hours. CSAT 1 hour. Map reading half an hour. And India yearbook half an hour. Which means 10 hours of study. I've told you 12 hours per day. So 10 hours of study plus 2 hours you have to solve the multiple choice questions. On those areas you have covered on that particular day. So I am splitting up the multiple choice question, which has to be done for 2 hours daily. So what you have studied polity, whatever you have covered in polity on that day, under that topic you have to do the test multiple choice question for half an hour. What you have covered in history, you have to do for next half an hour solving the question. What you have done in current affairs, that you have to do half an hour. Then what you have done in CSAT, that you have to do half an hour. So polity half an hour, history half an hour, CSAT half an hour, current affairs half an hour. 2 hours of solving question is very, very essential, because only when you solve the question, your mind will process the information very fastly. So the response time in the examination is very, very short. 100 questions you have to solve in 110 minutes, because 120 minutes you have. 10 minutes you have to give it for formalities. You have net 100 minutes only, according to me. So every question you have to attempt in 1 minute, and therefore quickly you have to respond. The response time is very, very less in the examination. You should be very, very fast. You should think very, very fastly, and this faster thinking can come only when you solve the questions. When you solve the questions, you can think fastly. So MCQs will have to be done daily basis. 10 hours of study plus 2 hours of MCQs. If you do this, then definitely in the next 8 weeks, you'll be able to complete the entire syllabus. You would have revised the entire syllabus. And this is what is going to take us to the next level called as main examination. Clearing prelims examination is very, very essential. Why? Because this is the first stage in the process. If we miss out in the first stage, then we have to wait for another 1 year. And that is very, very difficult, friends. So clear this year.